I understand you and your men have a job to do here, but we're in the middle of a 10-year-old's birthday party.
And I'm sorry, but we aren't coming in.
That's not a problem. We have nothing to hide from you. My husband's an honorable man. We're not who you think we are. So if I were you, I would start treating us with a little more respect, or I guarantee he will make it his mission in life to ruin you. Very disrespectful.
It really was just a story about these people, and the clothing and the places just became a part of that, and that's what Kasia sort of specializes in doing. She's a master at just finding the beauty.
I feel that my job as a costume designer is to see the underlying design in the film and to understand that underlying design and bring it to life.
She's also helping to design sort of iconography as well. So there are three or four pieces of wardrobe that reappear in the film. And as the film develops, you realize that those are sort of very specific, iconic things in the film.
Costumes is just like the last layer of the character. It's like the skin of the character.
I think the wardrobe is the key element to legitimizing photographing a film during this period.
This has been a really incredible process because it's almost quiet process when we can effortlessly find the same language and find similar images. The palette was driven by life, so we knew that we're embracing a lot of colors. I prepared this presentation, and when we met with JC, it was such a short meeting because it turned out that we both had almost identical images. So we knew that we probably speak the same language.
With a period film like this, it becomes even more important that the movie not just becomes some camp walk through the hits of the era.
It's always challenging to find great period clothing.
She traveled to Milan early in prep. Armani opened up their archives for her to find Jessica's look in.
So like with Jessica's fashion, you know, she's a person who is really striving to just be a part of this kind of American dream, or what she feels that is. She's recreating what she thinks that sort of success is, and that's a real fun thing to do as a director and as a costume department.
With Abel, she created the look from scratch, making suits and shirts that were the perfect fit and character for Oscar.
JC had one particular picture that he was very clear that that's how he saw this character.
Well, he's a guy who dresses the part. He wants to be a Rockefeller.
I think that the Standard Oil costume is as exciting as Anna's white long coat. We loved the thugs because we felt that those guys need to look like the guys that just blend in with the street rather than going for anything bigger. Costumes like that become really exciting in the end, even though it seems like it's the smallest choice. I was so drawn to filmmaking because it's such a collaborative process, and that's the best part of making movies. Really, it takes so many of us to produce each frame of the film.
Oh,